Hello students, in this video lecture I am going to take up a very important question that might have occurred in your mind sometime, and that question is there only one way of drawing Hass diagram of a PO set? If you are given a PO set, we know that we can draw, we can represent that PO set using a Hass diagram, but the question is, can the Hass diagram be drawn only in one way, or there are different ways of drawing the Hass diagram? Now for this I take up a example and I illustrate the whole thing through an example. Now let me take X to be the set 1, 2, 3, the set consisting of 3 elements 1, 2, 3, and let me consider the PO set which is the power set of X. The power set of X means the set of all subsets of X, and with respect to the inclusion relation, this we know that this is a PO set. So P, and to be precise, what is the power set of X? The power set of X is the set of all subsets of the set X, and in this case the set X is the set consisting of just 3 elements 1, 2, 3. So the power set of X will consist of 2 to the power 3, which means 8 elements. So 8 elements are there because 3 elements are there in X, so 8 elements will be there in the power set of X, and those 8 elements are the empty set or phi, then the set of singletons, that is set of consisting of one element only, which means the set 1, the set 2 and the set 3, these are all subsets of X, and then the sets consisting of 2 elements only, which means that the set 1, 2, the set 1, 3 and the set 2, 3, and then the set consisting of all the 3 elements, which means that the set X itself. So these are 8 sets in all, and these are the elements of power set of X. Now if you just try to draw the diagram of the power set of X, then we know, we have discussed this in the earlier videos, that this is the how the Hass diagram looks like, where phi is at the bottom, just because phi is contained in every subset of X. If you take A to be any subset of X, if A is any member of the power set of X, then phi will be contained in that. So phi is related to every member of the power set of X, and so every subset, so phi is at the bottom, and because it's the zero of the PO set, so it's at the bottom, and then X is at the top. The set X is the topmost element, and again the reason is simple, that if you pick up any A belonging to the power set of X, then any A belonging to the power set of X, this will be contained in X. So any subset of X is contained in X. So this means any subset of A is related to X. So X is at the top and A is at the bottom. And then these are 3 elements of power set of X consisting of one element only, which means that these are singletons. They are single set elements or single set subsets of X. So they are at one level. So phi is contained in singleton 1, phi is contained in singleton 2, phi is contained in singleton 3, and again 1, 2, which is this element, 1, 3 and 2, 3 are the elements which are again at the same level, and 1 and 2, both these are contained in 1, 2. So this is how the diagram goes, that there is a line from here to here, and then there is a line from here to here. So this is what we have, and then again 2 and 3 are contained. This is 2 and this is 3. 2 and 3 are contained in 2, 3, so there is a line from this 2 to 2, 3, and there is a line from 3 to 2, 3, and again if you consider the element 1, 3 over here, then here I'm darkening this line, then 1, the singleton 1 is contained in 1, 3, and singleton 3 is contained in 1, 3. So these elements are here, and then X is at the top. So this is how the Hass diagram of power set of X looks, like a cube, and in fact it's called a cube. And if I just show you, just see, this is these are magnets, these are actually magnets which children play with, something like this. These are the magnets, and with the help of these magnets are available for play purpose of children. Children can play with it. Now with the help of these magnets, by joining, because this one you can regard as a vertex, and this one you can regard as a relation, and when I just draw the hash diagram, then the hash diagram, I have put it on a box so that the shape doesn't get disturbed. All these are magnets. So this is the diagram. This is how the hash diagram of power set of X looks like, where X consists of just three elements. And if I just lift it like this, it will almost be similar. It is just similar to the diagram which I have just drawn on the screen. And now if I just leave this cardboard here, now this is the cube. This is the hash diagram of the power set of X, but you can change the shape. I'm changing the shape by stretching this cube a little, because these are magnets, so I can just change the shape like this. And now if I change the shape like this, the relations don't change. The relations still remain the same, you can see, but the shape has changed. So this also is a hash diagram of the given PO set. I'm turning it round so that you can see it for your from every angle. So see, so this is another way of representing the hash diagram of power set of X. And now this is not, again, this is not the only way again of representing the power set of X. Now who said that these relations, these lines, this one is the empty set phi, and the element at the top, just see the on the screen, I'm marking the element on the top. This particular element at the topmost element is X, and this is phi, this is X, and these three elements are singletons, and these three elements are the subsets of X consisting of two elements only, 1, 2, 1, 3 and 2, 3. So now, but who said that these lines should be of same length? No, there is no such rule in hash diagram, which means that I can change the length of the lines, which means I could have done something like this. If I add this particular piece over here and I just try to change my hash diagram, something like this, just see, I have added this, I have made this line a little longer. Now still again, these three elements are here, 1, 2 and 3, singletons, and then these are the elements, these are the subsets of X with two elements, and this is the element at the top. So this is another way of representing the hash diagram. The moment I make this line a little longer, the hash diagram changes, but still it's the hash diagram. And again I can change it furthermore by adding one more stick to it, let's say. So this is, in a way, I'm playing games with my diagram, with my hash diagram, just to get different shapes out of it. Now see, I've made this line a little longer. So as long as these singletons 1, 2 and 3, as long as they remain down, they remain below these upper elements, 1, 2, 1, 3 and 2, 3, this is the only requirement, that these are the three elements, 1, 2, 1, 3 and 2, 3. So as long as the singletons, these are the three singletons, so as long as the three singletons remain below the subsets of three elements, there is no harm in drawing the diagram the way you want. So this is another way of drawing the hash diagram. The only requirement is that phi should be at the bottom, which is the empty set, the set X, this should be at the top, and singletons should be at the first level. And then above the singletons, you should, singletons means that subsets having just one, subsets of X having one element only. And then above subsets of X having one element only, there should be subsets having two elements only. So this is how, this is another way of drawing the hash diagram, just see. So there are so many different ways of drawing the same hash diagram, which answers the question that we started with in the beginning. And that question was that, is there only one way of representing the hash diagram of a PO set? So now you know the answer, that hash diagram of a PO set can be drawn in many ways, provided the PO relations, the set doesn't change. You don't have to change the set, the underlying set should remain the same, and the relations between that should be correctly depicted in the hash diagram. That is the only requirement. and but the, it's not that you can draw the Hass diagram only in one way. So that requirement can be met in many ways. So Hass diagram of a particular PO set can be drawn in many ways. So that is the answer to the question we were looking for.